There we go. So there's nothing more personal than brewing a cup of coffee. And in my household, there are two different methods. Let me introduce you to mine. So this is the Mocha Master, and it brews a really great cup of coffee. And every morning, I put in the same amount of beans with the same amount of water, and the machine brews it with the same temperature for the same time, and it makes a really great cup of coffee. And at 6 in the morning, it's about all I can handle. On the other hand, my husband's brew method looks a little bit like this. So he uses different devices, different grind sizes, different temperatures, and really kind of plays around with all these different variables in the quest of the perfect cup of coffee. So the question is, who brews the better cup? And perhaps the more pertinent question for us today is, how does this relate to education? And really, what's at play in our household and what's also at play in our schools is a debate over efficiency versus effectiveness, where being efficient is doing things right versus effective is doing the right thing. And some people in schools think we have it figured out, that we've got this well-oiled system and we should just keep churning out students. But at what cost? So I work in the International School of Beijing's Futures Academy, and it's a program built on the foundations of interdisciplinary project-based learning, and we really value the students exiting the program with dispositions for lifelong learning, and we've had the opportunity to play around with some different variables that we hope will make effective schooling. So I'm going to share three of those with you today, and the first one has to do with sequencing of subjects. And in secondary school, tradition holds that we run subjects concurrently and they're in these little boxes. But what we found out that in projects, perhaps it maybe looks more like a relay race, that we might start with one subject and then pass the baton of learning to another. And maybe we'll circle back, but not always. And when you think about it, isn't that how the real world works? So a second variable that we've played with is the yearly calendar. So early in our program, our students had like a passion project time that ran once a week, but we really found that students lost traction or they just weren't taking a lot of risks to try something new. And we thought, how could we take that time and chunk it up a little bit differently? What if we moved it to 3 times a year and had 3 weeks that we call Ignite Weeks, where students could really delve very deeply into their passions and interests, but also get support from experts to upskill. And a third variable we've played with is reporting on learning. And this is where we've leaned quite into effectiveness and perhaps getting a little crazy. But so reporting in Futures Academy looks a little bit like this, where we report out 5 times a year at the end of each project and at different times for grade 7 and grade 8. So how did we get there, and what did we learn along the way? Well, we couldn't have done this without asking questions. And it's been really important to us to embrace the design process and reflect on what we're doing and make small changes as we go. Because things will get messy, and we've learned to not only accept it, but embrace it. And we couldn't do this alone. That collaboration is essential. So these are some variables that we've played with and we've changed with, but it doesn't have to be these big things. It can be really thinking about what small things you could do in your classroom. Is it taking time to develop relationships? Is it perhaps starting the year and really using routines to make thinking visible? Or is it taking time to have one-on-one, face-to-face conferences instead of providing maybe written comments that you're not really sure if your students see? Or is it really digging into that co-teaching relationship and seeing what opportunities that might give you? Because the interesting thing and the big lesson that we actually learned is that when we think about effectiveness and efficiency, it's actually not either or, it's both. And as Ron Richard says in Creating Cultures of Learning, that when we aim for effectiveness, it almost always brings us more efficiency in the long term. So it's just like my husband when he brews coffee in the morning and he tries out all these different methods, you know, it takes some time at first. But each time he does a brew, he takes some notes, and with each iteration, the process gets faster and faster. So today, I'll leave you with this. I'd just like you to consider, what small little things could you do in your classroom to make learning more personal and therefore more effective for your students? Thank you.